Hi, this is Pastor Gary. I'm a member of the pastoral team at Newport Assembly of God. Thank you for joining us today. We pray that our time together will help you to know God, be His people, value others, and change our world.
Welcome to Newport Assembly. I am Lauren Ritzman. I do the announcements, and to establish some normalcy, I thought I would do them for this recording. To keep things normal, not that I am normal. Spring cleaning at the church is coming up April 4th. This will be from 9 to noon. All are invited, including all the men that have completed all the wives' to-do lists. In the event that it is canceled, please just go ahead and keep going with your spring cleaning. Keep doing it. I know your windows and spoutings have never looked so good. Also, in that same vein, if you are getting a start on your spring cleaning, make a pile of spiritual books and Bibles that you have read and that you're finished with and looking for a home for, and keep them for bolo or dinner table. We would love to have them. We set up a table that is available for anybody that is attending bolo or dinner table. So go through all your books and find some books for us. The Wings of Kindness barbecue and apple dumpling sale has been canceled. And I feel bad about this because I love that chicken. Refunds will be distributed in the near future, but you know, I bet all those chickens are breathing a sigh of relief because they have gotten a stay. And also, please submit your picture for the new church directory. We have some spaces that do not have pictures, they only have names. And now is a perfect time to experiment with that hairstyle or that makeup that you've been watching on, that tutorial that you've been watching on YouTube. So experiment and take a picture of yourself and email it to Pastor Bill at bw6706@gmail.com. And we can't guarantee that that picture will go in the church directory, but you know the church office will have a good time looking at those pictures. So remember to do that. Thank you.
Let's join for a time of worship together. Wherever we're at, whatever we're doing, it's always time to worship the Lord. He is worthy of praise. God is good. Lord, we just pray right now as we worship you right where we're at, God, that you would just meet us in this place, in this moment. Lord, may this worship be the fuel that brings us closer to you and prepares our hearts to receive your mighty word that is alive and active and make us to be more like you. Be praised in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's worship the Lord together. Jesus.
Assembly, I cannot tell you how much I miss you. I can't wait until we're all back together again in this house of worship. But I know it's not just about attending church, it's about being the church. And I know you're about our Father's business. Wherever you are right now, sequestered as we all are, I know you're about our Father's business in whatever ways you can do that and make that possible. I want to give a special welcome to all those who are joining in with our church worship. As we get together in this abbreviated time of worship, during this time of challenge. We are experiencing an unprecedented moment in our lifetime. I mean, we are all in uncharted territory. Our nation and world are still trying to figure out how we're going to address this challenge. The good news about crises, this is not the first crisis that our world has faced, and it won't be the last. And we will get through this. Everything may return to normal, or some things may change, but we will all get through this. All of us are experiencing various levels of discomfort. You may feel vulnerable to disease due to some existing physical condition. You may be concerned due to your age, or you're concerned about some family member who is in their 80s, or some friend and who might be susceptible and at risk. Some of you are concerned about losing your job. Some of you have lost your job, and you're really struggling financially. You're wondering if it's all going to come together. I want you to know God loves you, and He is aware of what's taking place in your life, and He cares about what's happening to you. And as we trust Him, He will guide and provide and take us through this stressful situation. He will bring us to the other side. I want to share a couple of stories with you and then apply some biblical truth. And I pray this will encourage you as you walk forward in the days and the weeks to come. Yokoi Shoetsi was a sergeant in the Imperial Japanese Army in World War II. When the tide of battle began to turn, he was stationed on the island of Guam. And he determined not to be captured by the American forces, so he ran into the jungle and he hid in a cave. He later learned the war was over by reading the pamphlets that American planes dropped into the jungle. But he still feared being taken prisoner, and so he remained in his cave. And for over a quarter of a century, he came out only at night, and he existed on frogs, rats, roaches, and mangoes. How about that? He was discovered in Guam, in the jungle, on January 24, 1972, by some shrimp fishermen. He was then 57 years old, and they finally convinced him to leave the jungle. Now, I want you to contrast that individual with the life of a Robert Reed. Reed was a full-time missionary in Portugal for 21 years. He's a graduate of Abilene Christian University. And following graduation and prior to moving to Portugal, he taught at a St. Louis Junior College. And during that time, he ventured overseas on 5 mission trips. That's kind of where he got the bug. You may think that is relatively unremarkable, except for the fact that Robert has suffered from cerebral palsy from his youth. He's been confined to a wheelchair for most of his life. His hands are twisted, his feet are useless, he can't bathe himself, he can't feed himself, he can't brush his teeth, he can't comb his hair, he can't put on his own underwear. His shirts are held together by strips of Velcro, and his speech is garbled and slurred. The disease keeps him from driving a car, riding a bike, or going for a walk, but it didn't prevent him from becoming a missionary in Portugal. He moved to Lisbon alone in 1972. And there he rented a hotel room and he began studying Portuguese. He became fluent in the language. He found a restaurant owner who would feed him after the rush hour and a tutor who would instruct him in the language. And then he stationed himself daily in a park where he distributed brochures about Christ. He shared his faith. And within 6 years, he led 70 people to a relationship with the Lord, one of whom became his wife, Rosa. He returned to Abilene Christian University in 1993 and completed his master's in missions. And to this day, he continues to serve God and his fellow man in various ways. Robert says his cerebral palsy has produced a great opportunity to meet people, to share the good news of the gospel, and to encourage them to rise above their disabilities and all the fears that those disabilities engender, and to see life challenges as stepping stones and not as stumbling blocks. I presented two men and two stories. Both men were presented with life-changing obstacles. One was a prisoner in a cave, the other a prisoner in his own body. They both faced fears, fears for their todays and fears for their tomorrows. One chose to follow his fear, and the other chose to follow his faith. The one who followed his fear wasted almost 28 years of his life. The one who followed his faith experienced a relationship with an all-powerful God who enabled him to accomplish incredible tasks despite his limitations. One was a captive in a prison of his own making, and he chose to remain in his prison of fear. The other was born in captivity to a disease, but he chose not to allow that prison or its fear to dictate how he would live his life. Folks, there are many turns in the road of life. Sometimes we can control what takes place, and sometimes we can't. Things just happen. But here's the bottom line. Life is all about choices. Choices determine the direction of our life. Choices determine the accomplishments of our life. Choices determine our fulfillment in life. Choices determine if we will live by fear or if we will live by faith in God. In the light of the discomfort that you may be experiencing today, I encourage you to hear God's word to you for this moment in time. Listen, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Will you choose to believe the word of God, or will you choose to surrender to the fear and anxiety that is so prevalent in the culture around us? Another one, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Will you choose to believe that God has a great future for you? Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct your paths. Will you choose God to trust? Will you trust him to direct your life? For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. If you haven't already done so, will you choose to believe upon Jesus? He has a wonderful plan for your life. He wants to give you a full life, an abundant life, not just pie in the sky by and by, but here and now, in this moment in time. Many of you have been living in relative isolation for some time. Do you remember wishing that you had more time to spend with your wife, or your husband, or your kids, or spend some time with God? You never had the time, now you have the time. Choose to spend some quality time with God during these days of quarantine. Choose to spend some quality time with your family. Perhaps distance requires you to do that by Skype or FaceTime or something, some other form of technology. Choose to reach out to others who may be struggling during these challenging days. Choose to invest your life, not just spend it. Invest your life in serving God by serving the people that he loves. Invest in something larger than yourself, something that will outlast your time on this planet, something eternal. Whatever you do, don't hide in a prison of your own making. Get out of the cave, get out of the jungle, and choose to live by faith and not by fear. Would you join me in prayer? Father, I thank you for your word that's able to give us courage and peace of mind. It's able to give us direction, guidance, wisdom. It's able, God, to steer us through difficult times, even like times that we face today. And God, we just choose right now to commit our lives and our families, our marriages, our kids, our churches, our jobs, our future. We commit it all into your hands. And God, I pray for those who may not have a personal relationship with you. I pray, God, that you would help them right now as they reach out to you by faith. God, cleanse them of sin, which is just disobedience to you. We're all sinners. We all fall short of the glory of God. And God, as they reach out to you by faith, I pray that your Holy Spirit would come and dwell within them. And God, you would make them a brand new creature in Christ. And Lord, we'll thank you for what you do. In Jesus' name. Thank you for being with us today. Special thanks to those who pray and provide financial support for Newport Assembly. To donate, you can click the link below, or you can visit newportassembly.org. If you enjoyed this message, please take the time and share it with a friend. Thank you so much.